Red Wings fans, stand up. Yeah, we gonna throw them wings up.
Wings up, wings up.
Show the league that this is our time. Let's make the city proud. We gon' win the Stanley Cup.
Stanley Cup, Stanley Cup.
After that we gonna party. We gon' show everybody. We show them all around the world.
We show them all around the world.
We show them all around the world. We gon' throw them wings up. We gon' throw them wings up,
Their big line on the back end, those two, and the big line starts up front with Boone Jenner, former Red Wing Gus Nyquist, and Oliver Bjorkstrand, who scored two goals. Stenlund just called up from Cleveland into Josh Anderson. He showed you in the open in that fight. He's out for a while. Anderson, the guy they counted on for Goldsmith, but only got one. Scores! The Red Wings got one! First and first point for Adam Erne as a Red Wing. They lead 1-0.
Well, Adam Erne let this go on the fly. That's the way to handle it. He didn't handle it. Beautiful setup right in the wheelhouse by Franz Nielsen, and no chance for a goaltender if you hit the net on a shot like that. We'll take a look when we get a chance.
There's the extra skeeter. Back to the middle, and Wennberg let it go through his legs. But the Jackets able to recover anyway. Werenski couldn't keep it in. They'll go back to get it. Delayed penalty here to Detroit. They're onside. Here's Dubois. Oh. In front, they score! Atkinson to the net.
What a tip that was.
Sure was. Cam Atkinson's fourth goal, the past five, his ninth on the season.
Goalie. And he goes right to the hot spot. Beautiful setup by Dubois, and a great deflection. And if he played 82 games a year against the Red Wings, he'd have 82 goals, Atkinson. He is red hot against Detroit.
You know, and he hasn't been playing with Dubois, who set him up there for most of the year. We mentioned he's missing Panarin, and yet Anthony Duclair said after, you know, he challenged me, but I had to commit to training and be consistent, and he's done that to his credit. Oh, here they come again, and they score again.
What a play that was. Oh, my.
Bjorkstrand's just been red hot.
Well,
and Columbus takes a 2-1 lead.
Almost blindly, Detroit won the draw, but then lost the battle here. The puck's turned over. My mistake, it was not Werenski. I thought it was. It was Gus Nyquist who made that play. Holy mackerel. Wow. What a play by Nyquist, and a nice finish by Bjorkstrand. Wow. Unbelievable.
You know, when the Shanahan plan came in, the Shana plan, after the lockout in 04, 05, 05, 06, and the rules changed a little bit, they score! We'll get back to that as the Red Wings have tied it up. And another one, two for Erne, his first two as a Red Wing, and this game is tied at two.
Well, it's great to see a puck going in for Erne, too.
Yeah, he's a hard-working guy. Maui with a shot. This one, this may have gone off Glendening. He may get an assist on the play as well. Can't really tell, but I bet you he will. And boy, you've got a juicy rebound like that with a wide-open net. No chance for the goaltender. And Ernie's going, wow.
But much better here in this building. And 7 for 28 the past seven games coming into the night. Columbus couldn't clear, and Bertuzzi's got it back to the man who gave him the puck, Hronek, to Mantha, back to Hronek. Hook the shot, scores! Tipped in front of the goal! Dylan Larkin! Well, they haven't been shorthanded much lately. The previous three games, shorthanded 12 times. So taking fewer penalties can help, for sure. Knocked down, they score! Bad bounce in Columbus's favor. A great bounce, bad one for Detroit. And it's tied up as the Blue Jackets get a power play goal.
Wing Daly off his stick and off the goaltender and in. Bad break there, yes. But what a great play by Jones. Right here, he could have shot the puck. He wanted to shoot the puck. Decided not to and went back to the boards. And then this whole play develops, and they get the bounce they wanted to tie the game.
And that goal will be the periods, Mick. It hasn't been changed to Bertuzzi, but in fact we have Bertuzzi from Mantha and Hronek, not Larkin. Bertuzzi from Mantha and Hronek is how it reads. Scores!
Oh my.
As the Blue Jackets have taken a 4-3 lead. And sure enough, Pierre-Luc Dubois, their goal leader, has his 11th. Seven last season. He's got his 11th this season.
Boy, oh boy, you see what he did? That puck was actually on its edge. Watch this thing. And it's like a knuckleball. And it just completed.
And a broken stick for the Blue Jackets. Jenner without one.
We're going to recognize now. Green recognizes it. Take your time.
Mantha waits, spins, shoots, hit the goalpost. Mantha in front of the net. Ernie a shot. Puck is loose. Hronek, good kick save and a beauty to hold it in. Finds Mantha off his stick, couldn't find it. Cleared by Bjorkstrand. Gives it back. Empty net for the former Red Wing. Nyquist seals it. 5-3 Columbus.
And there's the bad bounce on Mantha. Nothing you can do about that. Nyquist.
The Columbus Blue Jackets.
Boy.
The last team to win a game, not scoring first. They were 0-10-5.
Our power play kind of, I think it took us, took some momentum out of our game. I thought we played the style that they wanted to play. You know, I don't think we spent enough time in their zone. And, they're a heavy team, and they like to grind down low, and we spend a lot of time in our zone defending. It's tough to go and get some chances at the other hand when you're tired. But personally, you know, I think I got to find a way to make that fourth save and, stay in the game 3-3 there.
What kind of a break was that? Tough break, obviously, the one that went off of Daly's skate. What kind of a momentum sucker was that for the guys?
Well, we had one on the other side, so... you know, that's hockey. You know, you're trying to create chaos, and especially on the power play, you're down one guy, and I think you just got to put it to the net.
When Bernie thought that they sucked you guys into playing their game here tonight, I'm wondering how you saw it.
Yeah, he's right about that. They played a good road game on a back-to-back, and when we needed to, we didn't come out there in the third and come hard enough, and they get, it's a game where there's not many chances both ways, but they get one chance there with Dubois going down, and made a nice shot, and we responded, but it was too little, too late, and couldn't get it done on 6-on-5, so it's just we didn't generate enough in the third or enough all game to really push back from a one goal. We were down one goal there.
To your point right there, 21 shots on the game, not many coming into the third. What were they doing to limit your opportunities?
They got good big skating defensemen, so they made it hard to get to the middle. We knew that that was going to happen, but I don't think we generated enough off our forecheck and really sustaining time down there in their zone. So, we need to address that before we play a Toronto team on the road.
How good do you feel for Adam Ernie? He's been grinding it out all season. Finally got his first 2 points as a Red Wing tonight.
Yeah, I feel really good for him. I thought he was one of our best players tonight and provided a spark. And, you could see with the celebration on his first goal that it was a big relief for him, and rightfully so. It was a great shot and great play on both of them. So he was the spark we needed tonight, and he brought it. We didn't have much energy to start this game, and he brought that for us tonight. So it was a huge plus for our team.
You said after Thursday's game that was repeatable, and then you guys won in Montreal, and I understand there were a lot of sick people Sunday, but why do you think there wasn't more of that repeatable performance tonight?
You know what, I thought at times it was there, but not enough guys going. We need to get back to that, and we watched film from that game, and we thought we played well for two games there, and then tough back-to-back with some circumstances, but we need to get back to that hockey, and I thought at times tonight we did, but we didn't make it enough about us tonight, and we didn't work enough for each other out there, and I think that's what we did so well in Montreal is we were supporting each other and playing fast there just wasn't enough that tonight.
We always talk about how players' confidence breeds more confidence, and you had those two goals and looked like you were getting a lot more opportunities and looking to shoot it after that. How did those two goals boost your confidence tonight?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it took a while, but I'm just happy to get it, and disappointed we couldn't come away with the win, but hopefully get something started there.
Was your first celebration of relief that it finally went in and you looked?
Yeah, it was for sure. I mean, it's a long time, and I felt like I was playing good hockey, but it just wasn't going in, and hopefully it'll start going in now.
It just kind of seemed like you were all over the ice, especially after scoring those two goals, and you got Rob right there on the goal line in the second period there. I mean, how far is your performance tonight going to go moving forward for you?
Hopefully they're just going to start going in. Like I said, I feel like, slowly I've been getting better and better, and as the team has, and hopefully they'll just start going in.
How difficult was it for you maybe not to press a little bit too much or continue playing your game, because you do bring that physical element that's always been there, but the more you're not scoring, how much is it play on your body?
Yeah, I mean, everybody wants to score, but at the same time, if I wasn't scoring, I was trying to contribute in every way that I could, whether it was being physical or just being a leader on the bench and keeping the guys positive. But hopefully they'll start.
We came out first 10 minutes. We were playing good. Gave up three shots, I think, at that point, and then we gave up 10 the second half of the third. I thought we didn't get pucks out of our zone when we should have got pucks out of our zone. I thought they come down hard at you. I thought we had opportunities to get pucks behind, and we didn't. We mismanaged the puck there, and then I thought that carried forward to the second. As the second period went along, we looked like a super. I guess I'd use the word unconfident team that just slapped the puck around instead of had moxie and poise and understand the difference between carelessness with the puck, where you're throwing the puck, where you're turning pucks over at bad spots and taking unneeded risk. Understand the difference between that and just throwing the puck away. Like my 9-year-old plays hockey, and he's allergic to the puck sometimes. He gets rid of it as fast as he can, and that's the kind of the way we played, and that's confidence in moxie and swagger. But we're the only ones that can give us that. Like, I'm not saying that as an excuse, because it's not. We got a whole bunch of guys that are good hockey players in that room that aren't playing as good as they can, so we got to pick it up and find ways to play way better hockey than that. Lack execution on passes, end up, just don't create any offense. We're a little bit better in the third, but I shouldn't even say that. I thought once we got down, we had moments of being better in the third. We had some moments of some real plays and things like that. It's a kind of a nothing play in the fourth goal. It's unfortunate, but we got to be way better. I'd have to go back and see in the first there. In the second, we killed penalties and played D zone coverage, so it's hard to shoot the puck from your own end. I also think we still pass up too many shots. Even at the end of the game there, Bert's got a real look and he tries to make one more pass, and we just gotta be a team that shoots the puck. We're obviously we gotta be committed to that. Yeah, it's frustrating for sure. We said after last game too, we don't want this thing to snowball, so we better show up on Saturday against Toronto. Like, we better have a great effort. I thought we came out. I thought some guys worked hard, but not nearly good enough. Like, some of our best players got to be way better than they were.
Is it true? I mean, you even get goals from your fourth line.
For sure.
Like, maybe you have, yeah.
Yeah, for sure. I thought Adam Erne had his best game as a Red Wing. Beyond scoring, I just thought he was impactful. I thought he had a good game. So, we got some guys in our room that have been really good players for us this year, and they got to rise their game up. We got to be way better.